Hey there, Jim Eskeman, actor on the road. And as you may have surmised, I'm on the back lot of Warner Brothers. And this is the bandstand, the music stand. It's kind of in a town square setting here in Warner Brothers. And I worked here, I want to say 15 years ago. It's got to be something like that. In the last picture that George C. Scott, the great actor George C. Scott, ever did, which was a remake of the film Inherit the Wind. And I got to work with George C. Scott in that bandstand. No, we weren't playing instruments, but we were having a big, you know, participating in a big political rally of some kind. And I just remember he was just two things: very charming, wonderful man, but did not brook fools easily. Wasn't terribly patient with people who were dicks, among which I did not count myself. But there was somebody, as he was delivering some sort of a speech or part of his dialogue, there was someone who, like me right now, was filming him on a camera or a phone or something, probably not a phone at that time, so long ago. And he stopped in the middle of his monologue as he was shooting and said, "Excuse me, all due respect, piss off," which I thought was a very gentle way of putting it. And then the other thing I remember is that he told us a story, the assembled actors and those actors who were in it, I'm sure would remember this story about a little black child, two little black children that were talking about what's the fiercest creature in the jungle. And one little boy says, "Well, it's got to be the lion." And the second little boy says, "No, it's got to be the crocogator." "So what's a crocogator?" He said, "Well, that's a creature that has got a crocodile on one end and an alligator on the other end. And he's got two heads and on either side of his body." And the other little boy says, "Well, if he's got two heads like that, how does he defecate?" And the other little boy said, and I'll do it in George C. Scott's voice, "He can't. That's how come he's so fierce." So the joke fades a little bit in the poor retelling, but I'll never forget that George C. Scott moment. He was truly, truly a great actor. And he even did a great job in this last film of his, where he was, I think, in quite a bit of pain and quite ill. And anyway, it's one of those Warner Brothers memories that I'm happy to share with you. Okay, thanks for watching.